Hey everyone, if you're looking to record computer games, whether you want to share an instant replay with your friends, or maybe you want to get into streaming or video recording, you obviously need to figure out how you're actually going to record those games on your PC. And actually, there's a few good options open to you, which I wanted to cover in this video. I'm mainly going to be covering how to record sort of static videos and not streaming, but actually some of the stuff I cover will apply to streaming too, especially with capture cards and dual PC setups, which I'll cover a bit later on in this video. But for now, I wanted to dive into all the different ways you can record your screen, and the first way is to use the Xbox mode, or the game mode the Windows now calls it. So when you're in Windows and playing a game or whatever, you'll press Windows key and G, and that will actually open the game bar, and from there you can then hit record, which is in the top left under capture. So you click that, and usually it takes a few seconds, and then over on the right it says capture status, as you can see there, and it just keeps recording, and then you can play your game as normal. And then once you're done, you can just click on the stop recording button, and it says the game clip recorded, and then back in the top left you can click on see my captures and view everything back, or you can open File Explorer just to view it there, or you know, put on a YouTube clip or anything else, or you can just watch it back as I'm doing there. But that's quite a good option, and it's built into Windows, so it's free. The next option is to use the recording options that come with your graphics card software. So AMD Software if you've got an AMD graphics card, or the NVIDIA App if you've got an NVIDIA graphics card. I'll start with the AMD Software because it's actually pretty good, and you can do recording and streaming through the same software, whereas it's slightly different with NVIDIA, as we'll look at later. But with AMD, you can, under the record tab, you can choose which monitor you want to record in, and then when you click on record, it just goes through and allows you to actually set things up as you would like, and you can choose whether to record the desktop or just record actual games. If you wanted to just record games when they're in like full screen mode, you can actually just open the overlay with Alt and Z and record that way. What I'm showing now is more of the desktop settings and things like that, then it's got things like upscalers and denoisers built in. And for streaming, you can actually build scenes, so you could actually set up your webcam and have you appear in the bottom right and things like that. And then under the settings for both recording and live streaming, you've got loads of different options. You can configure this to upload directly to Twitch. So there's actually quite a lot of different settings, and I think the AMD software has come on loads in recent years, which is great. When it comes to recording static video and stuff, you've got lots of different options. You can record at like 4K up to 120 FPS if you want, and there's loads of other settings too. And then when things are actually recorded, you'll get that in your videos folder, and just a little clip there, as you can see there. And the NVIDIA approach is similar, so I've got an RTX 5080, but a lot of what I'm talking about can apply to like the 40 series cards and everything else. If you've got a slightly older NVIDIA card, that's absolutely fine too. And the way you would tend to record with NVIDIA is, again, you open the overlay with Alt and Z, and then when you're actually in a game, you can see there's the record option there. But obviously what you can also do is actually press, I think it's Alt and F9 to just trigger a recording, as you can see there. So it says recording has started, and once it's finished, under File Explorer you go to Videos, NVIDIA, and then the game that you've recorded, and you've got your recording there, and it's all really easy actually. And if we come back to the NVIDIA overlay and go to the settings and video capture, what you can see is there's loads of information there. You can do things like instant replay so you don't lose footage, which is really cool, or you can record static clips, and you can, you know, do H.264 or AV1, which just results in smaller file sizes, and actually it's really good. But if you're more into streaming, you can check out the NVIDIA Broadcast app, which is a separate one, but that's more designed for live streams. The next option is to record your screen with OBS, and OBS is a complete classic. Whether you're recording or streaming, it's a really good option. And of course, it's free, so who doesn't love that? And by default, you can do loads of different things. You can record your desktop, you can add webcams and things like that, and can configure the view exactly as you would like. And, you know, there's loads of different options, you just have to play around. But if you wanted to record static games, what you should probably do is do game capture instead, because that's a more efficient mode than display capture. So you can't see anything there because I haven't got a game open, so I'll just go back to display capture. But what you will need to do for OBS is go through the settings and make sure you're recording in the correct settings. It might be if your graphics card is weaker, you record at 1440p, for example. Audio, you might be able to leave as it is, but when it comes to the output, you want to go at least to the video encoder. Make sure software is not selected, because ideally you want to be encoding via your graphics card, not via your CPU. It'll be more efficient through your GPU. In my case, I'm going to the hardware and video option, but if you've got an AMD graphics card, you can choose the AMD option. But make sure you go through OBS and, you know, configure everything as you would like, and then you can start recording or streaming really well. So OBS is free, but if you've played around with it and maybe it's having too much of a performance hit, you could try out Bandicam, which is a paid for rival, but there is actually a free version, and even the paid version isn't super expensive. But actually, Bandicam has been known to be fairly efficient when it comes to recording. And this is their website, so you can just Google it and go to Bandicam. And yeah, it's a lightweight screen recorder software, and it works quite well, and it can record 4K with no issue at all and quite high FPS rates too. But it is a paid-for software if you actually, you know, don't want a watermark and things like that. And it's not super expensive, but it's not super cheap either. But if you have any questions, go to the FAQ section, because that talks about the limitations of the free one. For example, you can only record up to 10 minutes, and there's a watermark, which isn't always ideal. Next up, if you were looking to actually record short clips to share with your friends, or maybe, you know, you're making more vertical style content, then Metal.tv is actually a pretty promising option because it's designed with that exact goal in mind. There's an alternative though, which is Action by Mirillis, and it's actually a rival to Bandicam and things like that. It is a paid for bit of software, but it does have a 1 month trial, I believe, and it's also a pretty good option for actually recording gaming clips and things like that. So those cover the software ways of actually doing things with just one computer. But what you can actually do if you're really serious about recording or streaming and not having any FPS slowdown whatsoever and no stutters or anything like that, is actually have a dual PC setup. So what you'd actually have is like your main gaming computer, and then you'd get another computer, which could be lower powered, although it can't be too lower powered. You can't just have like 2 gigs of RAM and, you know, an Intel Pentium or something. But as long as it's sort of decent, what you can then do is buy a capture card from a company like AVMedia or Elgato, and then you actually connect your monitor and your keyboard and mouse to that other computer, which sounds like a weird setup, but essentially the output from your main gaming computer goes into that other computer via the capture card. And what that allows you to do then is press a button in your capture card software, or in OBS, because OBS supports capture cards too, and there's going to be no FPS drop off whatsoever, because your gaming computer doesn't, you know that it's being recorded. It's just simply outputting the gaming graphics via HDMI or DisplayPort into your capture card, and then your other system will actually record that with no FPS drop off whatsoever. Obviously, that is a more expensive option because you need to buy the capture card, which isn't exactly cheap, and you need to have that second computer and make sure that computer has a PCI Express slot free. But if you were really serious about taking your streaming or content creation to the next level, then a capture card can work out really well. The one final option is to simply record your screen, which won't exactly work for streaming and things like that, unless you had a very vloggy atmosphere and you kind of wanted to show yourself and the screen. But obviously you could just set up a camera, get a separate camera, put it right in front of the monitor, and you might need to play around with the settings on the camera to make sure it's optimized for screen recording. And I'll actually put some details of that down in the description, but simply setting up a second camera and actually recording your screen directly can be a fairly decent way of doing it. But of course, there's an extra cost because you then need to have another camera, and actually it might actually be cheaper to go and buy a budget computer with a capture card. That can be a better option. But that really sums up all the different ways you can record your PC games for content creation or streaming, and I hope you found this video useful. If you've got any questions though, please let me know down in the comments. And other than that, thank you for watching this video. Please click the thumbs up button and subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.